Now, our next report takes a look at the life and death of Hamza bin Laden and what it means for the future of the dreaded terrorist group Al-Qaeda, which gained notoriety for the September 11, 2001 attacks in the United States. Remember, the U.S. intelligence has reportedly confirmed that Osama's son and heir, Hamza bin Laden, has been killed recently. No confirmation has come independently from Washington, though. Here's a report.
Hamza bin Laden, the youngest son of the late Al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden, about 30 years old. Born in Saudi Arabia, raised in Iran, reported dead. Location, date or circumstances of death not known. Neither the US government nor Al-Qaeda has confirmed Hamza bin Laden's death, but US media reports citing unnamed officials claim that he died some time ago. Like the circumstances surrounding his death, even the information about his life and whereabouts is sketchy. According to American government records, Hamza bin Laden was born between 1986 and 1989, which puts his age at about 30 years. He's said to be the youngest son of Osama bin Laden. He was born to Khaira Sabar, one of Osama's three surviving wives. He married the daughter of Abdullah Ahmed Abdullah, who was responsible for the 1998 bombings at the US embassies in Tanzania and Kenya. He's also reported to have married the daughter of Mohammed Atta, the lead hijacker of the September 11th attacks in the US. The US government designated Hamza bin Laden as a terrorist about 2 years ago. Hamza entered Washington's most wanted list after he released audio and video messages calling for attacks on the US and other nations. His last message dates back to March 2018 when he urged people on the Arabian Peninsula to revolt. The same year, Saudi Arabia revoked Hamza's citizenship. In February 2019, the US government announced a $1 million bounty on his head. According to some media reports, Hamza bin Laden narrowly escaped death on the 2nd of May 2011, the night U.S. Special Forces attacked Osama bin Laden's hideout in Abbottabad, a garrison town near the Pakistani capital of Islamabad. Hamza was reported to have visited the Abbottabad building just 2 days before the U.S. operation. Hamza bin Laden was inducted into the ranks of the Al-Qaeda as a young adult. After Osama's death, Ayman al-Zawahiri became the Al-Qaeda leader. Hamza was seen as a potential successor to the leadership of the terrorist group. Although Al-Qaeda is not the potent force it was some time ago, its ideology remains virulent. Some in Washington believe that Al-Qaeda is capable of mounting terror attacks either on its own or through the several affiliates or franchises it has spawned over the years. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.